Hi, this is Pragati. In this video, we will try and understand a few concepts which are influenced by the relationship between interest rates and foreign exchange. But before we dive deeper into the concept, I would like you to like, share and press the bell icon. At the heart of this relationship lies the concept of interest rate differential, which is the difference between interest rates offered by different countries. When a country's interest rates rise relative to those of its trading partners, its currency tends to appreciate, gaining value against other currencies, basically because of the increased attractiveness of higher yielding investments, drawing capital inflows and boosting demand for the country's currency. Recently, we've all been surrounded by conversations around following the Fed. Its significance can largely be explained by the need to maintain interest rate differential. Now, RBI often follows the US Fed's monetary policy decisions, particularly when it comes to interest rates. Now, this alignment is primarily driven by the need to maintain stability in the INR-USD exchange rate and prevent excessive depreciation of the rupee. When the Fed raises interest rates, the RBI often follows suit. Now, this synchronization aims to prevent a widening interest rate differential that could trigger significant capital outflows from India, and it also puts downward pressure on the rupee. Now, from here, we move on to understanding what capital flows are. The changes in interest rates can trigger significant capital flows, which is basically the movement of funds across borders. Now, when interest rates rise in a country, it attracts foreign investors seeking higher returns, leading to an inflow of capital. This capital inflow strengthens the country's currency. Conversely, when interest rates fall, foreign investors may withdraw their funds, causing capital outflows. This outflow weakens the country's currency. Capital flows play a crucial role in transmitting the impact of interest rate changes across economies. Now, exploring further, we encounter the influence of inflation differentials. Inflation plays a very important role in determining the real interest rate, that is, the interest rate adjusted for inflation. A higher real interest rate provides a more attractive return for investors, boosting demand for a country's currency. Now, say in a scenario where two countries exhibit varying inflation rates, the one with higher inflation might also have higher nominal interest rate. However, when adjusted for inflation, the real interest rates could be lower. Investors who are cognizant of the impact of inflation on their returns gravitate towards countries with higher real interest rates. When inflation rates in a country rise, the central bank may raise interest rates to withdraw the supply of money from the economy and thus curb inflation, which kind of maintains a positive real interest rate. This can help stabilize the currency and attract capital inflows. Now, to put all this theory into perspective, we'll consider an example of the European Central Bank and the Euro. The ECB, with its focus on price stability, adjusts interest rates in response to its inflationary pressures. This ensures that the Euro maintains its standing among global currencies, even in the face of diverse inflation rates across the Eurozone. So, in conclusion, by carefully analyzing interest rate differentials, capital flows, inflation dynamics, and the overall economic outlook, investors, businesses, and policymakers can gain valuable insights into potential currency movements and position themselves accordingly. Thank you.
Mutual fund investments are subject to market risks. Read all scheme-related documents carefully.